The Electric Sailplane Clinic Number 2 is the latest how-to video from Radiocarbon Art Productions. In this two-hour intensive training program, expert Paul Naton teaches you every step of the process of building and optimizing a 3.5-meter electric glider for sport and competition soaring. The first Electric Sailplane Clinic taught basic electric terminology and hardware techniques, and it's recommended that you learn this material first, as we will be using the technical terms and basic assembly skills in this more advanced program. The main focus of this two-hour training program will be the conversion of a 3.5-meter F3J sailplane into a lightweight but fast-climbing electric glider equipped with the best hardware available, ready for altitude-limited competitions as well as performance thermal flying. You will first learn how to pick and soft test a motor and prop combination using the popular eCalc web-based power calculator. You'll see how changing prop diameter and pitch affects pitch speed, thrust, and overall motor efficiency, and how to adjust those parameters to keep your power system within its safe operating limits. You will then learn how to install and test a lightweight geared outrunner system with the latest high discharge batteries providing power. Paul teaches you a variety of skills, from fabricating a custom firewall to static testing the power system to gather real performance data. Other subjects covered in detail are custom programming your ESC with computer software, ESC data collection, LiPo battery testing and maintenance, how to set up BECs and LIFE receiver batteries, spinner installation tips, radio programming tips for electrics, and altitude limiting switch installations. After the detailed power system installation, Paul takes you to the flying field for some pre-flight safety tips and the glider's first powered test flight. We then take a look at some of the flight data collected to see how our power system is performing as compared to the computer simulations. The Electric Sailplane Clinic DVD training series is the most comprehensive program available to teach you the skills needed to safely and professionally build, maintain, and test any electric-powered glider and its components. Radiocarbon Art offers a discount for buying both electric clinics together, and if you're not satisfied with any of our products, you can return them for a refund. Purchase this and other high-quality instructional soaring DVDs at our website, radiocarbonart.com. All credit cards and PayPal are accepted. Please keep watching. A short preview clip from the DVD is included in this preview trailer, starting now. Another useful graph is the milliamps of your battery used. You can see this is the orange line as Terra steps up. Run the motor, we've depleted a little bit more current. The ESC is calculating that. And you can see at the end of our flight, we did about a minute and 10, minute and 20 of motor run, and we depleted about 800 milliamps out of our 1200 milliamp pack. And when I came back and charged the battery, I put about that much in. So this graph is pretty accurate. So obviously you can see that the data the ESC is collecting is super useful. One thing I've noticed is that my amp pull in flight is a bit lower than I was shooting for. Shooting for around 50, I'm getting like between 40 and 45. That tells me that I could probably go up a little bit in pitch. I'm flying an 18.9 for this test. I could probably go to an 18.10 or maybe even an 18.11 and still be around the 50 amp range. I mean, it's pushing the motor pretty hard, but for the short durations I'm doing, that's not going to be a problem. The ESC temps are staying really nice, so I don't have a problem there. And it looks like the battery pack is definitely up for the task too. So I'll try a little bit higher pitch and do some tests later. Now, I've been flying the Ionix JW Electric for about 4 weeks now and have been doing a lot of testing with it. I have to say I'm really happy with not only the soaring performance, but the climb performance under power as well. Now, we started out with a 68-ounce airframe, and adding the power system, we've only added 8 ounces, which is not too bad at all. In fact, I usually fly this plane with a pound of ballast in it if there's any kind of wind or the lift is good anyway. So this is our 18.9 prop setup, 65C pack with the Hacker motor. And what we're looking at is a data download from the RAM 3 digital altimeter from Soaring Circuits, and I use this to track altitude climbs. Now you can see on the chart here, doing one 30-second climb. Now the weather conditions were a little bit harsh on this test day. It was blowing 12 knots, so I was climbing into a 12-knot headwind. The temp was 95, humidity way up there at 83%. So my density altitude was definitely high, and that's definitely going to adversely affect the climb rate. But I still managed to do 867 feet in 30 seconds, and that's a 1735 foot per minute climb rate, which is not too shabby at all for this lightweight of a setup. If I had a cam unit on board, Looks like it would have shut off in 22 seconds. That's 200 meters or 656 feet. So I had about an 8 second cushion where I could go forward upwind before I went to pull up and do the full 200 meter climb. So the motor system's definitely got enough power for contests. And again, the airplane weight is definitely down there, and the thermal's great. You can see on the right here, I did a nice 403 foot climb out in just a couple minutes, got up to 1270 and then came back down. Again, the airplane flies great.